far can art take you?
I'm trying to get a lift east.
Are you headed west by chance, dude? No.
Two artists have 40 days to cross the United States. They start with just $1.
$1.
And right across America, they must rely on their artwork to pay for every meal, every ride, every bed for the night.
Yeah, I wonder why I did this whole project.
They may not cross more than three state lines in a week.
Come on, buddy.
And when their journey ends, they must fill a gallery with their work.
It's a lot of white space.
The winner is the artist with the greatest takings. The loser hands over every last cent from the trip.
This is a great and horrendous and beautiful and horrible trip.
Their journey is the art of survival. Their journey is Art Race. Previously on Art Race, Ben and his artwork have been getting stuck in the South.
I would love to be able to say yes, but I'm going to have to take a pass on it.
Oh, no problem.
I wish you luck.
Okay, thanks.
While in Colorado, Kenny's portraiture has gone to the dogs.
No, it's a real way to make a few dollars. And then they're not staying still. They're like, blah, blah. And so you picture what you get, what you think will be a right angle, and it's like, blah.
But Kenny's doing well and finds himself almost $600 in the lead. In his bid to reach New York, Ben has now traveled 3,500 miles to Nag's Head, North Carolina.
I love the coast.
I feel like I've made it, and I still have really a long way to go, but it's a weird feeling of, like, I'm basically here. That's how I feel. It's just the smell in the air that I'm familiar with. That's all it is.
Kenny is still 800 miles from his home in Los Angeles. He's in Grand Junction, Colorado, and is trying as hard as he can to find a ride west.
This trip is all so much chance. Who you happen to run into that day. Are you guys going to Moab? Please, pull over.
It's day 32, and Ben has a plan.
My host and idol is Pat McManus, a surfboard shaper and a surf champion from the East Coast. He's going to collaborate with me on a homemade surfboard project. And he's also offering me a bed for the night. This is Pat's house. This is Pat's shaping studio. This is Pat's private collection of surfboards. He's like 1,000 in there. For the first time in my life, I'm having my first hack at a homemade surfboard.
If you're ready to step up to the plate.
Yeah, I'm ready.
You're going to want to cut into it. See this collar right here?
Yeah.
That's going to go right up against the side of the template. Gotcha. Try not to tilt it, because that will also mess up the curve of the outline, because you'll be making a wavy curve.
Yep.
So just take it slow and just remember, let the weight kind of hold on it. Okay. Just watch that blade.
Yeah. I was getting to the point where I was really, really hungry. And after setting everything up and all that he's done for me, ask him if he had any food. But I think that the seriousness of the race and of the competition and everything sinks in when you tell somebody, like, you're actually hungry. And they're like, whoa, this guy's not joking. Like, he hasn't eaten today.
I don't even want to think about how much time I've wasted waiting at the side of the road. You guys going to Grand Junction? Can I come? Well, finally I get a ride about 40 miles west past Cisco. My plan is to get to Moab, Utah. I was stuck in Grand Junction, and Jonathan's van rolled up. They just made a delivery of, help me out here, guys. Dinosaur tourists? What?
Yep, family's here to explore dinosaur fossils.
So, dinosaur fossil tourists. And I convinced Jonathan to trade me a little a ride further down the road here to Cisco for a little drawing of Ian here. And basically, we're going out into what we think is basically almost a ghost town of Cisco. but it is on the right crossroads, so I'm praying it'll get me home. Home being Moab.
If I was to take a board back and sell it in the show, if you would feel more comfortable with me taking more of a beater and doing the artwork, and then you can use that board. Because I don't, right now I can't pay you for a blank, I can't pay you for the work you've done, whatever. Yeah. I can negotiate something with you where I pay you later after I sell it. The only thing is I don't want to go and take a board that you could conceivably turn into a $700 board.
Well, let's just, I don't want you to take some piece of junk like this.
But no one would know the difference, really. My plan of doing surfboard art turns out to be a little more challenging than I predicted. This is the same stuff the surfboards are made out of. This is the foam. And we're gonna put a layer of glass, fiberglass, resin down, and fiberglass to see if my materials run, because we don't want them to smudge once the board gets its coating of fiberglass. Obviously, the problem with surfboard art is you have to make it waterproof. This is the moment. Let's see what happens here. Unless the resin has a chance to set up, this is going to be a complete disaster. It looks like...
Impossible.
Passable.
Now, what I'm going to do now, though, is I'm going to pull this.
Move it.
Oh, man.
It does smudge, but that took a lot of work on your part.
Yeah. That was a lot of moving.
Yeah.
Basically, I'm on the only road into Moab. There are two roads into Moab. This is one of them. So everyone that drives by this down this road is going to Moab. So even if only four cars pass, it's a good chance I'll get a ride. Can I get a ride to Moab? Can you give me a ride to Moab? Can you give me a ride into Moab? What's that? What's that? I gotta get to Moab. Are you going?
Girl, I'm not supposed to pick up hitchhikers.
I'm on a 40-day road trip going from New York to LA. It's a adventure. And you'll hear about it.
Okay, cool.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Awesome.
Girl?
All right. Heidi's convinced that I'm not a psycho and drives me all the way to Moab. It's a gorgeous 30-mile ride. I'm starting to become much more ambitious about my art trades. The Colorado River flows out of Moab. This is rafting country. I want to see if I can do my next leg of the journey by raft. So we're gonna go talk to some rafters right now. Heidi's like, it's Red River, let's go. I'm in the process of doing a cross-country trip, New York to LA.
Okay.
I'm a painter, I'm an artist. And I've been making my way across the country, basically bartering and trading drawings, ink drawings, and oil paintings, such for food, lodging, and transportation all the way across the country. So, and it's a race. There's another artist going the opposite direction to complicate my life.
It's a huge honor to be working on a board by not only a really good shaper, but a really good surfer. It's sort of like an added pressure, you know? I have to design this and I have to make it beautiful and I have to make it look like something you'd want to hang on the wall. But at the same time, I have to be kind of careful that I'm not like gouging into the surfboard, even though it's tempting because it's such a nice material to work with. But it's gonna be my adventures depicted all the way across the surfboard from west to east. That's what I'm thinking. And I can't possibly run out of things to draw.
I think we could work this out to do some sort of raft trip trade for a painting. But he can't do the trip. He calls his buddy. There he is.
What time do you want them there? Okay. Okay, excellent. Bye. Done. You're going through cat to height.
Sick. Sick, that's gonna be awesome.
The truck will meet us at height, and you'll go through Cap and see some really big whitewater and some amazing canyon lands. So 7 o'clock tomorrow morning.
That's good. Cheers. Hey, gentlemen.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Salud. This is gonna be a fun, exciting deal. How much do these trips cost, by the way? How much does Navtech cost per charge per head, more or less?
I think a one day.
It's like $360.
Yeah, it's $360.
Good.
Day 33 starts with a surf with Pat. It's a really humbling experience. Pat's a champion surfer, and I'm not. Afterwards, Pat introduces me to his friend Roscoe. He's going to apply the glass job to the surfboard.
Really, charcoal is about the worst material one can use on a surfboard in the sense that you're trying to avoid smudges, and charcoal's all about smudging. But I kind of like that. It's kind of like introducing new materials to, you know, it's like the, I don't know, it's really rocking the boat.
Yeah, here it goes, guys. Yes.
It's kind of weird. I'm used to stirring up my resin with hardener, and this stuff you don't stir.
Well, the charcoal is bleeding a little bit through the fiberglass, the fibers in the fiberglass. So it's now mixing in with the resin, but all it's doing is giving a little bit of a tint to the entire board, which I'm okay with. What I was scared was gonna happen is it was gonna make visible smudges. I have to go right now to the local radio station, and I'm gonna be asking all of Cape Hatteras and beyond for a ride out of here.
All right, so sketchbooks and radio are in here. My big pack is gonna go with the support with the trailer that picks up the raft. And that's it, We just basically, I'm not taking anything extra on this boat because it's gonna be, from what I understand, there's something like 2- and 3-story drops, like huge waterfalls, like not waterfalls, but huge rapids descents. That big motor will make us skip along the top, basically. That's the plan, at least. Yeah, it's a little frightening, but very, very exciting. Everyone's like, woohoo! It's gonna be great, so.
I have interviews lined up with 4 different radio stations. The time has finally come to really sell myself.
Yes, I lied. I'm not going nowhere. You guys are stuck with me. Ben has made his way to the studio. Ben Sargent.
Right now, I got a guest in the studio, my friend Ben.
102.5 The Shark, Mr. Gordon Lightfoot, giving us those rainy day people on a Monday afternoon. I'm Mike Campbell here. And hey, I got a special guest in here.
Ben, how are you, buddy?
I'm good. How you doing?
So what exactly are you doing?
I'm basically racing across the United States.
His only thing is, he's trying to get there by, well, I guess selling your art or trading with your art.
I haven't had any calls, not one. Whereas when I was in Marfa, Texas, it was like 1, 2, 3. People were lining up outside just to meet me, say hi, and nothing yet.
So we're on the Colorado. We're heading up toward Canyonlands and eventually Lake Powell. We're on a motorized raft. It's fast, very fast.
Is there anything you'd like to appeal to the audience about while we're here on the air this afternoon?
Well, I'll just say that I'm a good companion on the road, and I'll keep it lively. And that's it. We'll have a good time traveling north. I've appealed to tens of thousands of listeners, and nobody could care less. Oh, well, too bad for me. Oh, man.
The tough thing is, there are 2 parts to this. One is the experience, And now I have to do the art to make up the art trade. Stop for lunch. I'm trying to get a little drawing done. They maybe hear a slight roar behind us. That's the rapid number one, Brown Betty, starting half a mile away. Sort of the calm before the storm, so I'm doing a little drawing of the valley here. Working lunch.
The radio station's a total disaster. Curtis, the manager, is so embarrassed, he even steps in himself. Possibly he just wants me off his property. Any luck?
You need a ride somewhere?
I need a lift.
Up the road?
Up the road.
I have some pity on you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Really?
Uh-huh.
You're gonna
I'll
help
take
me?
Take you, yeah.
Oh, man.
I'm gonna do it.
That's awesome.
Yep.
That's awesome.
You're just going up like 5 miles, right? And then just drop you off there?
I don't know about that.
More like 2 hours?
What, you know?
Hour and a half?
What can you swing?
Whatever I can
what
do.
What can you swing? Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll take it.
That's awesome. Yeah. Love the Vans. Really. Curtis drives me back in the station's van to Pat's place to pick up the artwork and say goodbye.
That was really fun.
Yeah.
I had a great time.
Thanks, Mark.
See you, man.
Thank you. It seems Curtis not only wants me off his radio station, but he also wants me out of his state. He drives me 130 miles north across yet another state line into Williamsburg, Virginia.
Cataract Canyon has some of the toughest rapids in the country. Huge waves crest the bow. At times, the boat feels like it's completely underwater. It also gets me 117 miles closer to Los Angeles and closer to the end of the line. If you do something wrong, it could be really dangerous. Unbelievable. This was great. I'm on the adrenaline come down right now. What this fun little adventure got us was actually got us a ways down the road. I was in Moab here and I'm heading toward Vegas and LA. And we actually split this entire length of Canyonlands. We basically cut right through the middle of what's called the Grand Loop, which is a way you see a lot of Capitol Reef and Canyonlands and arches and all that stuff, and we just bisected it. I did a drawing for the trade, for the rafting trip, and so it's very glassy here, and right there, the rapids start. So that's how I liked it. I liked it with sort of the calm before the storm. And honestly, I didn't want to get this out of the dry bag once the rapids started, because we were up to our knees in water. At the end of the day, the guys dropped me off at a little hotel in a little town called Hanksville. I have just enough money for a hotel room.
Thank you so much, man.
Thanks for coming into my place, man.
Definitely. Thank you guys for the awesome tour. It's goodbye to Charlie, Carl, and Brian.
Curtis is my hero. He gets me right into the center of Williamsburg. We arrived late, but I'm grateful to be there.
I expected I was gonna get maybe 20 miles out of the Hatteras Outer Banks area, and I really got about 120 miles out. I'm like, Ben, your only job is to just keep talking, make this guy have the best ride of his life, and maybe he'll be willing to take you there. That's my tree.
Seeing as how I have no money, I end up sleeping right on the side of the road. I can't really afford to go anywhere or do anything, but this traveling lifestyle is beginning to suit me.
I've totally scarily gotten used to having no money in my pocket. And I've also gotten used to the idea of asking people for food, which is, it's a crazy thing the first time you do it, when you're actually hungry. And you have to ask someone if they have any crackers. It's hard.
A local artist will be hanging her show that night in a downtown cafe. I decide to call her and see if she might share a little space in her exhibition.
Talk about being a mooch. Congratulations on your show. Can I be in it? Hey, Rebecca, my name is Ben Sargent.
She seems a little amused by my proposal, but she seems like she might be up for it.
In some way, jump in on your show.
So I arranged to meet her that night.
I guess you could call it art survival.
The problem is, now I need to come up with some artwork.
Thanks, bye.
I wake up in Hanksville, and I know I gotta move southwest. It's already over 100 degrees, but I wanna try to get to Escalante, or maybe even all the way to Bryce Canyon. Inevitably, it's back to hitchhiking.
I just switched over here because this is the intersection of 24 and the 95. So basically, it's a meeting of two highways. Everyone going that way is heading west. Eventually, you could go south or north to Escalante or north toward back toward the 70s.
The problem is there's no vehicles on the road. Then these three women roll up.
So what are you doing? Are you painting?
I'm trading
sketching?
Drawings and this and that for like accommodation, for food, for whatever I can get. Oh. I'm Kenny.
Kenny. Hi, Iris.
Iris, nice to meet you.
Chris.
Nice to meet you, Chris.
Hey, Kimberly.
Nice to meet you, Kimberly.
We can fit you in.
We're just taking another route back to Vegas.
Wow, so
we're flying out tomorrow.
I wish I could grab a ride with you guys, because but it sounds like you guys are full.
How far do you need to go?
As far as you guys want to take me.
We're going back to Orlando, actually.
I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do this evening. I know that it has to be, can't be offensive in any way. No profanities, no nudity.
By this stage in the trip, I'm not at my all-time most creative, but I gotta come up with something.
I'm trying to make a little bit of money today, and I'm also trying to just use some of my sort of leftover materials. Excuse me, sir. Could you take a quick photograph of me? Okay, all right, it's real easy. Just gotta come real close. This is the button right here. It's an old Polaroid camera. Aren't they great?
A long time ago.
Those in your closet.
That's the one. And come right close up. Okay. Good. Well, I'm thinking I'm in the wrong town for this kind of art, but I'm thinking that I could see this hanging in the gallery in New York, and at the very least, my friends would appreciate it. And I like that it's just was done here, sitting out in like the most conservative place in the United States on a bench, bored, trying to figure out my next art project. Whether it sells here or even in New York, it's part of the drama and fun that can go into art.
I decided to trade a portrait for my ride, but man, it's a tough crowd.
That's right, this is all about Kenny. What Kenny likes, what kind of music.
Are you driving fast enough? Give me another Fritos. I'd like a bottle of water. Can I have your water, please?
Can I have your ice cream, water, please?
Yeah. Can I have some of your milkshake? I want a float. No, not here. We're going to
mine. At least the food's coming out. Excellent.
Thank you. I turn up to meet the artist, Rebecca Snow.
That's Rebecca, the artist. Behind me, very close to me.
Hi.
Within reaching distance. I'm Ben.
Nice to meet you, Ben.
Good to meet you. Sorry I'm a little late. I can help you set up if you need help.
I had it all laid out on my apartment floor, so that I know.
I can't help but noticing there's a little difference in our styles. Colonial art really isn't my thing. This may not have been the best idea.
It's serious work. Don't laugh.
Yeah, no, I'm not laughing.
It's very serious.
I get it.
Yeah, these were my emotions that I went through today.
Yeah, they're not very colonial.
No, they're not super colonial. Maybe, I mean, ideally I would sell it as an entire set.
For how much?
I don't know. In LA, I got $1,000 for a piece like this.
Wow.
All right, well, just so you know, I'm probably only going to just use, like, right there.
You know, $1,000 to me right now would be a tremendous amount of money, but, you know, people coming through, their tourists, they hate to go home with any money in their pocket.
$875. I took the price down a little bit. That's just because I removed one image from the collection. So it just seemed to be a fairer price.
Closing time, and still no buyer. The story of my life.
Next time on Art Race, Kenny is on a roll.
I like this. You guys hang out more. You guys hang out more.
While Ben makes a superhuman effort.
Listen up, Kenny. Your watercolors are mine.